Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to talk quickly about percentages, decimals, and some rounding issues that may hold you back as you complete your statistics course. In the first example I have here, it says in a survey of 2015 people, 28% of them said they thought the local school taxes were too high. How many people thought the taxes were too high? How would you solve that problem? Hopefully you know how you would solve it in your way, and that is to take the 2015 and multiply by 28%. Of course, when you multiply by a percent, you could use your calculator and use that percent button, or you can change it into a decimal and multiply by 0.28 in this case, because you would just move the decimal point two places to the left. So if you take 0.28 times 2015, you get 564.2. Now, if they ask you to round that answer to the nearest tenth, you could leave it that way. But we don't ever have 2/10 of a person. So sometimes when we're asked a question like this, we would then say the actual number of people might have been 564. It might have been 565, because the truth is statistics is not about getting an exact number. Finding an approximation for the whole population based on the data set from the sample set is what we're all about. So if we say it's 564, it could be 564 or 565. It's not exact. In fact, sometimes using numbers that are too precise are misleading. So if we were writing up a study, we might say about 560, like even to just get off the whole thing of having an exact number. But you should know how to multiply percentage times the sample space set number to get the number that they're looking for. All right, in the second one, it says in a survey about smoking, 346 out of 914, should be people, believe that secondhand smoke is dangerous. What percent of the respondents thought secondhand smoke is dangerous? Round your answer to the nearest hundredth of a percent. How would you get that percent in the first place? Well, you would take the number of people who thought it was dangerous and divide by the total number of people in your sample. So if we look at that, 346 divided by 914, that's approximately 0.378555 dot dot dot. It keeps going. So it's said to round to the nearest hundredth of a percent. This number is not a percent right now. So don't round it, because what happens is people round that to 38 and 0.38 and then they get 38%. It's not correct to round before you actually have a percent. So first change this to a percent, then round. How do you change to a percent? You multiply by 100 and move that decimal place over two places. Now we have 37.8555 and it continued on percent. So now we can round that. It's approximately 37.86%. How does the rounding work? Remember, look one to the right, and if the number is five or greater, we increase the number that was to the left of that. All right, so that's one thing. And the other thing I want to mention about percents is that percent values range from 0 to 100, or if you look at them as a decimal number, 0 to 1.00. It doesn't make any sense to say we had 150% reduction in crime, because 100% represents the entire data set. So when we take it down by 100%, we're down to zero, right? We can't have 150 reduction. And people say things like that sometimes. We had a 400% reduction or whatever. So you can't do that. But sometimes people do talk about percentages that are greater than 100 if they say we reached 120% of our goal, because we had a goal to raise $100 and we got $120. So you can be over your percent in that way. But when you're reducing that, that does not really make sense. And then finally, if you're working with a certain number in your data set, and we're talking about discrete data, you can only get certain answers. For example, if you have a data set of 40, discrete means they're countable, right? So let's say you were saying how many people out of 40 actually come to class with a calculator on the test day. You had 40 students you're looking at. If one person came with a calculator, that would be 0.025 or 2.5%. If two people showed up with a calculator, it'd be twice as many. So we, instead of 0.025, we'd have 0.05. If three people showed up with a calculator, it's three times as many as our first one, which that would be 0.075. And if four people out of 40 showed up with a calculator, that's 10%. Notice 25%, 2.5%, 5%, 7.5%, 1%. What happens at 5? 5 out of 40 is 0.125. Notice that we're going up by 25 thousandths in every case, right? So we're just going up, adding 0.025 to each case to get the next one. So 6 out of 40 would be 0.15. And how am I getting those numbers? Just divide the top number by the bottom number. So these are the kind of values I would expect to see if I was dealing with 40. You can try that for any number and see the pattern that emerges. So if somebody said they had a sample size of 40 and 14% of the respondents chose their brand, you should see that 14 is not a possible outcome for this data set. If we're working with 40, we're never going to get 14. If we look at this, we could get 12.5%, even rounded to 13%. But the next one would be 15%. There's no way to get 14% with this data set. So be looking at that too when we're looking at maybe people falsifying information. Have a fantastic day.